Hey, church family, happy Good Friday, amen. Might have been a day of sorrow back then 2,000 years ago, but we're not looking forward to the cross or at the moment of the cross. We're looking back so we know what happened when our Jesus died on the cross. We know Sunday is right around the corner, amen. I want to welcome you to our Good Friday service. Every year we do this at church, and it's such a special service. I hope it's a special service for you. Hey, before we start off tonight, listen, all this stuff is at the admin building over here. If you want to stop by, get a prayer map, get our free devotional, get a prayer card, get the Psalm 91 card. They're all there for you. Amen. We're going to open in prayer tonight, and we're going to celebrate Jesus on this Good Friday, 2020, like none we've ever had before, all online, but it's all good. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we come before you, and we thank you for this day, Lord, the day that our Jesus gave himself up, the Lamb of God who took away the sins of the world. We thank you tonight that we've come to celebrate. We've come to remember the passion of our Jesus. We've come to partake of communion, and we've come to look at the Word of God of the suffering Messiah who would come. Didn't come on a white horse that time. He came on Palm Sunday on the donkey. But boy, he's coming back soon on that white, glorious horse, and we following him. We love you, Lord. We honor you in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Count on one thing, the same God that never fails will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out. Yes, I will lift you. I
welcome to CFFC Online. My name is Brandy, and I want to thank you for joining us. So listen, every service we say our vision together, so let's go ahead and do that. So we are a praying church. We are a going church, and we are a life-changing church. And we are reaching and impacting people with the love of Jesus. Well, we just want to thank you for joining us on this Good Friday service. It's awesome that you can be a part of it. Our Easter services are going to be Saturday night at 7 p.m. and then Sunday morning at 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. You can join us online. Also, our Next Gen Youth will be having services Thursday night and Sunday night at 4 p.m. Miss Ashley and Life Children's will be having her online services. She puts a lesson up each week. It's interactive. It's going to be an awesome time. So you parents of the Life Children's, you want to go ahead and log on to that. Also, we have a challenge for you. We may not be here on Sunday morning, on Easter Sunday morning, but we want to see and be part of what you're doing. So we're asking for you to send in some of your Easter photos. Maybe you have an Easter dinner and you can take a picture of that. Maybe your kids do an Easter egg hunt or they get Easter baskets. Well, we want to be part of that. So after Easter, go ahead, send those pictures in and we're going to put those online and connect with you that way. Any other questions, comments, if you have a prayer request, you can go to cffchurch.org and send those in. Well, thanks for joining us on this Good Friday service. Hope to see you soon.
Good evening, CFFC Church family. We're going to continue to worship by the giving of His tithes and our offerings because we are a giving church. Here's the ways that you can give. You can go to cffchurch.org and click donate at the top of the page or on this link on the video. You can give on our CFFC app. You can text to give by texting the amount to 84321 or mail your cash or check to 3188 Route 94, Franklin, New Jersey, 07416. Now here it is, Good Friday. Every Good Friday, I always take time to remember about the passion of our Lord Jesus. You know, I'm thinking tonight, what about in the Garden of Gethsemane? We see Jesus showing us His true humanity. He's asking God three times, Father, if there's any way this can happen without the way it's going to go, I'm all for it, right? But what does He say? He says, but not my will be done, your will be done. Jesus sacrificed everything that night. He gave up His entire life. Why would He do that? He did that because He loves God the Father. He also did it because He wants God's will to be fulfilled in His life. And there is a third reason. We're going to find that in Hebrews 12:2. Looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before Him, endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. The joy that was set before Him, that's you and that's I. You see, Jesus laid down His life for others. You know, I can't think of a better example than that. To give because you love God, because you want His will fulfilled in your life, and because you care about others. What an example Jesus is to us. What a Savior. Let's do that in our own lives. Let's be like Him, right? Amen, brothers and sisters. Let's pray. Father, I thank You, God, that we can make that decision to be more like Christ, Father. And Father, we know that Jesus was a giver. He gave it all, Father God. Thank You, Father, that we can give tonight. Father, bless this offering, Lord. Use it for Your purposes, Father, to bring souls into Your kingdom. And I thank You for that in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hi, CFFC family. Easter is almost here, and we want to celebrate with you guys. Be sure to check out our online services on Easter. Also, kids, we're preparing a special service for you on Easter as well. So be sure to check out our Life Kids Facebook page. We also want to see your favorite Easter tradition, or maybe just pictures of the kids in their jammies Easter morning or their Easter baskets. You'll see a post coming through on Facebook. Be sure to share a picture of the Easter baskets, the Easter your egg hunt, or even your meal. Just whatever you guys are doing to celebrate Easter, we want to celebrate with you guys. Hope to see you soon. We miss you all.
Hey, church family, so good to be with you on this Good Friday. You know, as the Jewish people are celebrating Passover, it began on Wednesday, and it runs through this week. Remember, Jesus Christ is our Passover lamb. It says in John 1:29, Diane, the next day John saw Jesus coming towards him and said, "Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world." He didn't just take away our sin. He took away all sin. Yeah. The Bible says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever would believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life." So our Passover, Diane, has come. Church family, our Passover has come, and it's glorious. It's glorious. I want to do something a little different. Before I get into the word tonight, we're going to receive communion together. And then, because I want you to see, we're going to look mostly at Isaiah 53. I want you to see the suffering Messiah and what he did for us. So go ahead and get your communion elements. I have them here. And we're going to go ahead and we're going to receive tonight. We're going to receive as a family, a church family tonight. Amen? Diane, the last service Wednesday night, you did the bread. I did the cup. Let's go in reverse today. Amen. I'll go ahead and do the bread. So you guys ready? You got your little piece of matzah there. You got your little wafer, your little bread, your little cracker. And it symbolizes the body of Jesus Christ that was broken for us. On that cross, he was whipped. He was pierced. He was beaten. He was spit upon, on and on. But that wasn't all of it. It was what was going on in the spirit realm also. Yes. That our Jesus sacrificed his life. And I love the way when John says here, "Behold the Lamb of God." Remember, the Lamb in the Old Testament covered the sins. But this one, this Lamb who takes away the sin of the world. You notice it's singular sin? They didn't say he's going to take away sins. He's going to take away that sin nature from us. Amen? And it's because of what Adam and Eve did that sin came into the world. As one minister said, it was through food that the fall came. It's through food, partaking of the bread and the cup, that redemption comes. So are you ready? My Lord Jesus, I thank you tonight for your broken body. And I thank you tonight, it's because of this sacrifice that we have redemption. We have forgiveness of sins, yes, plural, but of sin. Our sin nature has been changed. We have been born again. We are new creations in Christ. We are a new man, a new woman. So we take this bread tonight and we break it in our hand, symbolizing that Jesus' body was broken, and we put it in our mouth and we chew upon it. We taste and see that the Lord, he is good. We partake of the broken body. And the broken body was for our healing, for our physical man, for each part, physically, first of all, for us. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Diane.
Then we receive the blood. The blood of Jesus was poured out to completely wash away all of our sin. It changed our nature. And it put us into right standing with Father God. No matter what we do, this blood cleanses and purifies us, makes us holy and righteous, so that we can stand in the presence of Father God, just like Jesus does, completely pure and holy. So this morning, or this evening, as we partake of this blood, the blood of Jesus. The Bible says the life of the flesh is in the blood. We're partaking of Jesus' abundant life tonight. So we thank you, we praise you, Father God, that we are righteous because of this blood. We partake of it tonight in Jesus' name. We thank you.
Look at the crosses behind me. Yes. Our Jesus was crucified on the cross for me, for you. Thank you, Lord.
Oh, we thank you. We praise you.
I'm going to go ahead and read Psalm 91. I can go to God, Most High, to hide. I can go to God, all powerful, for protection. I say to the Lord, you are my place of safety, my fortress, my God. I trust in you. He did it all for us,
yes,
church.
He
did it all for us.
Yes.
God will save me from hidden dangers and from deadly diseases. By his stripes, we were healed.
Yes.
I can go to him for protection. He will cover me like a bird spreading its wings over its babies. I can trust him to surround and protect me like a shield. I will have nothing to fear at night, Diane, and no need to be afraid of the enemy's arrows during the day, church family. I will have no fear of disease that comes in the dark or terrible suffering that comes at noon. 1,000 people may fall dead at my side or 10,000 right beside me, but nothing bad. Go ahead, say it. But nothing bad will happen to me. All I will have to do is watch, and I will see that the wicked are punished. Diane, would you continue?
Sure. I trust in the Lord for protection. I have made God Most High my place of safety, so nothing bad will happen to me. No diseases will come near my home. He will command his angels to protect me wherever I go. Their hands will catch me so that I will not hit my foot on a rock. I will have power to trample on lions and poisonous snakes.
The Lord says, if someone trusts me, I will save them. When people say, oh, we can't be sure if we have eternal salvation, I'm sure.
Yes.
Because it's not on me, it's on Jesus.
Yeah.
I will save them. I will protect my followers who call to me for help. When my followers call to me, I will answer them. I will be with them when they are in trouble. I will rescue them and honor them. And I will give my followers a long life and show them my power to save. Amen.
What a great psalm. What a great psalm.
It's amazing, Diane.
Yeah.
It truly is amazing what Jesus Christ has done for us.
Yeah.
So as we celebrate the resurrection of our Jesus, I never want to forget what Jesus did on the cross and what we receive because of it. Again, behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. So would you turn with me to Isaiah chapter 53, and we're going to study right from Isaiah, the prophet, a couple thousand, you know, I'm not sure of the time factor, so let me not say it. But so many hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years before prophesying about the one who is to come. Amen?
Yeah.
So are you there in Isaiah 53? I'm going to read this from the New King James. Who has believed our report? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant and as a root out of dry ground. He has no form or comeliness. And when we see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. And Diane, I think about that because we see pictures of Jesus with the halo and all. Jesus, how did Jesus look? He looked like a Jewish man.
Yeah.
He looked just like a regular guy.
Sure.
But boy, that anointing. Can you imagine when he took the two, his three disciples, Peter, James, and John, up to the Mount Figuration. So here Jesus is that John laid on, and here's Jesus is that, you know, maybe they threw a ball or whatever they did for a little bit of leisure back then. And here he is, a regular Jewish man, right? But then the glory of God came, and his clothes were whiter than anything, and they saw Jesus, the Son of God. They saw Jesus, God himself. Now, the Bible says we're going to see him with flame. His eyes are going to be as if fire and his hair white, the Ancient of Days. I heard a minister say the other day, it was so good. I don't want to get burned by the fire that proceeds from his mouth because I want to be behind him, following him on a white horse. Amen.
Good.
Amen. Verse 3, Diane.
He's despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we did not esteem him.
And that's important to understand. He was despised so that we could be accepted. Yes. He was taken away from God. Remember on that cross, he cried out, my God, why have you forsaken me? Because Jesus was forsaken, we are accepted. Because Jesus took the pain and the punishment upon his body, we get to be accepted by God. We get the blessings of healing, the blessings of provision by God. Because Jesus was separated from God, we are born again when we accept the free gift. See, some people think, well, you know what? Jesus did it so the whole world is saved. No, you need to accept that God doesn't stuff anything down anybody's throat. You can accept Jesus or you can reject him. I chose to accept him.
I did too.
Amen. It was the greatest decision I made over 40 years, asking the Son of God to come into my heart, to be my Lord, to be my Savior. Now, verse 4 is a very special verse. Amen. Surely, or for sure. Amen. He bore our griefs. That word griefs, you can go ahead and look it up. It means sickness and disease. So he bore our sicknesses and diseases. He carried our sorrows, and the sorrow means pain of punishment that was placed upon him. Wow. That's why the Bible says when we get to heaven, there will be no more pain. There will be no more disease, no more suffering, no more. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new.
Yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions.
It's because of what we did,
Diane. Yes, yes.
Nothing he did. He was the spotless Son of God.
That's right.
But it was what we did that he was wounded for our transgressions.
He was bruised for our iniquities, our sins.
Our sins.
He was
Adam
bruised.
And Eve's sin.
Yes. At the sin of the whole world.
The whole world. Now, I heard, I don't know this as a fact, but they say the reason, if you go on Google and look up crosses with the skull at the bottom, they say the reason that is when Jesus died on the cross and that blood was shed, that skull at the bottom represents Adam. Adam was the one that God gave all dominion, God gave lordship to, and he committed high treason and he gave it away to Lucifer, to Satan. But the blood of Jesus went to the first person ever created, Adam. And I really wonder, Diane, I really wonder that where Jesus Christ was crucified, was that the place that Adam was buried?
It makes sense.
It
makes a lot of sense. But I mean, just to think the symbolism that blood completely covered the sin of the world.
And from the first man, the blood of Jesus covered the sins from the first Adam to the last Adam that ever walks on planet Earth. Amen. When we get raptured, we need to understand that there's still going to be 7 years of people on this earth, and people are going to live. People are still going to accept Jesus as their Lord and Savior.
Yes.
People are still going to have to make that decision. It's appointed unto man once to die, and then the judgment. Oh, thank God. Yeah, it's appointed to us that we must die also, unless the Lord returns, and then we're changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. But if the Lord doesn't return and we die naturally, it's appointed unto man once to die, but he took the judgment upon him. Yes. Then anyone that accepts him, the judgment is not placed upon us. Yes. In fact, the judgment that's placed upon us is the Bema Seat, rewards for what we've done for Christ. Amazing. So he was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities. Go ahead, Diane.
The chastisement for our peace was upon him. Our peace of mind. The crown of thorns was placed on his head.
Right.
And so he bore our peace as well, so that we could have peace with God, yes, but also peace in our minds, in our lives.
God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. You will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on him. Great is the peace of your children because they are taught of the Lord.
That's
Amen?
Good. And by his stripes, we are healed. And that's physical healing.
That's right, because that's scripture. People say, oh, that's spiritual healing. Well, you got to go to Matthew 8:17,
yes,
where he quotes this scripture.
Yes.
And what does it say he's doing?
Healing
people and casting out devils.
Yes, that's right.
And then First Peter says that by his stripes we were healed. So he looked
healed.
Back towards the cross.
That's right.
No, this redemption is for our physical bodies also. Amen?
Yes, yes, for our physical bodies, for our minds, for our, you know, our prosperity and health, you know, in every area. So all we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all.
Of us all. Of us all.
Of us all.
From
yes.
Adam
yep.
right through.
Right.
I mean, when you really look at the Bible, it's called the scarlet thread of redemption. Right from Genesis chapter 3, where God says, Satan, I'm going to bust that lordship over, to Rahab letting the guys down with the scarlet, right through the entire Bible. When you look in Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, on and on, look for Jesus. Look for Jesus. You see him everywhere. He is everywhere. Everywhere.
Yeah, because the whole story of the Bible is all about redemption. It was the fact that Jesus, that God wanted to bring his family back. And so it's all about redemption. It's all about Jesus.
And it was all about God doing.
Yeah.
You know, I think of the covenant with Abraham. What did God do to Abraham? Put him to sleep. He cut the covenant by putting him to sleep. How are we involved in this covenant?
We just receive him.
He did it all.
Yeah.
He went to the cross. He went into the bowels
yes.
of the earth. He rose on the third day.
That's
and
right.
the Bible says, whosoever shall confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, believe in your heart God raised him from the dead,
yeah.
he shall be born again. So in a sense, he put us to sleep,
yes,
and he
right.
says, just accept it.
Yeah.
Just the way Abraham had to accept
yes.
it.
Free gift.
Free gift.
Free gift. There's no charge. He paid a terrible price for it. But for us, it's free.
Diane, he was separated from the Father. You know, our little peewee brains can't comprehend forever.
Yeah.
Forever. Yeah. They were always together. Well, Pastor, what's a forever? It's a trillion years times a trillion years times a trillion years and just keep going on. There's no beginning, no end. And that's how we're going to live forever when we've been there 10,000 years, bright, shining as the sun. We no less days to give God praise than when we first begun.
That's so good.
English for you. You ready? If that was a little, you know, old-fashioned. When you're up in heaven and on this new earth for 10,000 years, it's going to be like you were there the first day.
So good.
Oh, I love that scripture. I quoted it the other day to you. When we're on this new earth, we're not even going to remember this anymore. Diane, I was thinking this morning, actually it was the other day, that C.S. Lewis called this earth that we live on right now a shadowland. A shadow is not, you know, it's real, but it's not real.
Right.
You can chase your shadow, you know, Peter Pan going after the shadow and all that. But this is a shadow of the real that is to come.
Yes.
This is the real. There's my shadow, my hand on the table. You can see it. We're really alive here. But the real is yet to come.
Yes.
Just a shadow,
yeah.
man.
Yeah.
Just a shadow. Hold on. He's coming. And he's going to take us home. Diane?
Verse 7. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth.
Wow.
He was led as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before its shearers is silent, so he opened not his mouth. He was taken from prison and from judgment. And who will declare his generation? For he
Jesus.
Was cut off from the land of the living.
Jesus.
For the transgressions of my people, he was stricken.
Boy, you got to chew on some of that, right? I mean, think of some of the things they say in here. He was taken from prison. Jesus was in prison from judgment. So he could be declared to this generation. He was cut off from the land of the living. He died on that cross. That's why the disciples, they saw those nails go in his hand. They saw the spear in his side and the blood and the water spilled out. When he came in that day, he said, look at me, guys. Real. I'm alive. He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Right, we got to hold that till Sunday, Diane.
Oh, sorry.
All right, no, I'm just teasing.
Okay.
Verse 9.
And they made his grave with the wicked, but with the rich at his death.
Hold on. Because you said this to me the other day. It was so powerful. That Jesus Christ, since he died a criminal's death, his body should have been tossed into a open...
Yeah, the pit.
Into a pit.
Just into a pit.
Poor man's
sure.
Pit. It should have just been tossed to the side. But the scripture said, right here, the fulfillment
yes.
of it, but with the rich at his death. As Joseph of
Arimathea, yep,
asked for Jesus's body. Was he thinking in his head, I'm fulfilling scripture right now? I don't think so.
I don't think so either.
He just loved Jesus.
And if he hadn't been in that grave, then how would we know he was risen from the dead? It's really amazing when you see the whole plan that it was all for a purpose.
And those of you that went to Jerusalem this past year, to Israel last year, glad we went last year, amen?
Not this one.
That
well.
You guys went last year because of this coronavirus. You can't even go into Israel right now. But you went there and you walked inside the empty tomb. I did this years ago, about 20 years ago. Yeah. Diane, you walked inside that tomb, just like the Bible says, in a garden. There was a garden. You walked over to the side and you looked up and you saw Golgotha. And you saw that it still looks like a skull, the place of the skull.
Yep.
But you saw that the tomb is empty.
Yep.
And they actually say it looks like only one person laid in that tomb.
Yeah, because there's the way they did the graves in those days, there was evidence that there was only one person.
Only one person.
But it's empty.
It's empty. Amen. It's empty. Come on.
It's good.
Come on. I don't want to forget. Write in comments there. The grave is empty.
Yes.
My grave will be empty too. What does that mean, Pastor? It means that if you were to die, you die today, you die tomorrow, whatever it might be, before the rapture comes and they put your body in a grave, when Jesus Christ returns,
it says, Lord,
the dead in Christ shall rise first. What do you mean the dead in Christ? Aren't they with Christ now? Yeah, their spirit and their soul is, but their body is here on the earth. And he promised us a body like unto his own, glorified like on his own. That dead body is going to rise up and be connected. I don't know how it's all going to happen, but it's going to be something.
It's going to be good. You
be
get
good
really excited.
Do I get excited?
Yeah, you
Diane?
Do get excited.
I love it. I love the word of God.
It's a good thing.
It's a good thing.
Yes.
All right. Where are we?
So, but with the rich at his death, because he had done no violence, nor was there any deceit in his mouth, yet it...
Now, this verse is key. Catch what Diane's going to say
okay.
right now.
Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him.
It pleased Almighty God to put Jesus to that cross, because for putting Jesus on that cross, his kids come back home. That scripture in Hebrews, I think it says, for the joy that was set before him, he endured the cross.
Yes.
You know what the joy is, Diane?
Us.
You are.
Yeah. You.
I am.
You.
You are. You were the joy that put Jesus on that cross. All that suffering that he went through, it was because of you that he loved so dearly. It wasn't about you sinning and you making mistakes. That was from the fall of Adam. Yes, our sins separate us from God and all of that. I understand that. But it was because he loved you so much that he said, I'll go to that cross. Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him.
He has put him to grief.
So he made him sick.
Yes.
He put disease on
yes.
him.
So that could be healed.
That's right. They say that every disease was placed on Jesus
yes,
Christ.
Everyone.
There's a lot of diseases, boy. Let me tell you. A lot of sickness.
Yeah.
Cancer was placed on him.
He bore it, so you don't have to.
Tuberculosis was placed on him. Back problems was placed on
him. Kidney diseases,
liver diseases, brain diseases.
Flus.
So receive healing now.
Yes.
Say this, Lord, it pleased you to bruise him. It pleased you to put him to grief. And because you did, I receive healing tonight. I receive healing to my physical body. If you bore it, I receive it. I received communion, Lord. I pray for my son. I pray for my daughter that they be healed now in Jesus' name. Wow.
Well, yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him. He has put him to grief. When you make his soul an offering for sin, he shall see his seed. He shall prolong his days, and the pleasure of the Lord shall prosper in his hand. He shall see the labor of his soul and be satisfied. By his knowledge, my righteous servant shall justify many, for he shall bear their iniquities.
Come on. Let's just hang out for here for a couple minutes. What? By his knowledge, my righteous servant shall justify many. Come on, you know what justify means. Yes. Type it in. Just as if I've never sinned. Justified is a legal term that means to be made right, yes. to be found not guilty. You've been justified. And here it says, not a few. Not 100, 1,000, 144,000, 1,000,000, 1,000,000. He shall justify many. Why? For he shall bear their iniquities. He bore my sins. That's why they say Jesus looked like hamburger meat on that cross, because the sins of the world were placed on him. You know what? Jesus could have endured the whippings. He could have endured the slaps, the plucking, the punching, the piercing, the nails and all that. But I believe with all my heart, and I think you'll agree with me, Diane, what had to be the hardest thing is when Almighty God, a holy God, turned his face and could not look upon his son. And Jesus cried out, my God, why have you forsaken me? Here is the spotless Son of God, never sinned. The sins of humanity are placed upon him. You see where I'm going here? And a holy, righteous God, God is holy, thrice times holy, 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 the Bible says. Holy Father, Holy Son, Holy Spirit. And here, he turns his face. They say, Jesus said, as Jonah was 3 days in the belly of the whale, so shall the Son of Man be. Read Jonah. Read some of the statements that Jonah made. It's our Jesus talking there. Powerful, Diane.
So good. So good. Wow. When you think of all he did for us. Verse 12. Therefore, I will divide him a portion with the great, and he shall divide the spoil with the strong, because he poured out his soul unto death.
Yeah. Well, it's just, hold on one second, because look what it's saying here. He's God is dividing to him a portion with the great. Jesus Christ is going to be known as King of Kings and Lord of Lords for all eternity, right? And then he says, and he shall divide the spoils with the strong. He's going to bless us with the spoils of his victory because he poured out his soul to the dead. Sorry, Diane, go ahead.
Don't be sorry.
All right, I won't be sorry.
And he was numbered with the transgressors, and he bore the sin of many.
There it is again.
And made intercession for the transgressors.
Made intercession for me. And for you. So in just the few minutes we have left, I just want to read. I'm not going to have time to, you know, really expound on these, but you should really expound on them. Turn to Colossians chapter 1 and verse 13. And I just want you to see what went on and what we receive because of what Jesus Christ did at the cross. Colossians 1:13. I'll read some, and then I'll have Diane read some. He has delivered us from the power of darkness. How? By the cross. Yes. He conveyed us into the kingdom of the Son of His love, in whom we have redemption through His blood. Amen. The communion. We have what, Diane?
The forgiveness of sins.
He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For by Him all things were created, that are in heaven, that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created through Him and for Him. And He is before all things, and in Him all things consist. Diane, go ahead, read verse 18.
And He is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things He may have the preeminence, for it pleased the Father that in Him all fullness should dwell, and by Him to reconcile all things to Himself, by Him, whether things on earth or things in heaven, having made peace through the blood of His cross.
Do you see that, guys? That is such a powerful scripture, amen? Yeah. For by Him to reconcile all things to Himself, whether they are things on earth, things in heaven, having made peace through the blood of the cross. The blood that Jesus spilled on that cross is just amazing. In a few minutes, Reverend Bob Meeker is going to come up, and he's going to pray. And he's going to pray what the blood of Jesus Christ has done. He's going to pray all that Christ has done. So be ready for that prayer in a couple minutes. Amen. And you, who once were alienated and enemies in your mind by the wicked works, yet now has He reconciled in the body of His flesh through death to present you holy and blameless and above reproach in His sight. Is that just amazing, Diane?
So good.
That's just amazing.
That is just so good.
And that's why I wanted to receive communion at the beginning. And I wanted to do Psalm 91 at the beginning. Because at the end here, I want these scriptures to set in. I want these words to set in. As we pray over you in a little bit, I want you to just grab hold of what He's saying there. We're going to read Colossians chapter 2 as we start wrapping up here in verse 11. It says, Diane, go ahead.
In Him you were also circumcised with the circumcision made without hands by putting on the body of the sins of the flesh by the circumcision of Christ. Putting off the body of the sins of the flesh by the circumcision of Christ.
Buried
with Him in baptism.
So when you're baptized, right, and if you haven't been water baptized, you should. You're buried with Him.
In which you also were raised with Him through faith in the working of God who raised Him, Jesus, from the dead. So we were raised with Him. And you, being dead in your trespasses and the uncircumcision of your flesh, He has made alive together with Him, having forgiven you all trespasses, having wiped out the handwriting
not covered
of requirements
wiped out
that was against us, completely wiped it away.
He washed away our
washed
what can
away.
Wash me
yes.
white as snow, nothing but the blood of Jesus. Amen.
Yes. And He has taken it out of the way. What? Our sins, having nailed it to the cross. So when He was on the cross, our sins were nailed to that cross with Him. Having disarmed principalities and powers, He made a public spectacle of them, triumphing over them in it.
Now think about saying here. Yes. He's saying that when the Romans conquered land, when we went to Rome once, me and Diane, and we went to the ancient city of Rome, and you see the Arch of Titus there, and when you look at it, you see the all the imprinting on them. You could go on Google and look at it, but it's all the imprinting of them, the captured, coming in. And here it says, having disarmed principalities and power, he made a public show of Satan, of the demons that are in hell, of the fallen angels, yeah, triumphing over them. As we wrap up here, I want this one part to stand out. Having wiped out your sins, if you accept it, Jesus as your Lord and Savior, and all the requirements of the law have been washed away because of what Jesus Christ has done. Amen, church family. We love you. Happy Good Friday. It's so awesome to know what Jesus did. And Saturday and Sunday, Saturday 7 p.m., Sunday 9 and 11, we are going to celebrate the resurrection. Usually we're packed out in church. Let's be packed out online. Amen. Would you bow your heads with me as we wrap up here? Father God, I thank you for what you've done tonight. And I pray, Father, if there's one person in the sound of my voice that has not accepted this wiped out experience, Lord, they'll accept it tonight. If you're here tonight and you have never asked Jesus to come into your heart, to be your Lord, to be your Savior, and you'd like to do that, then pray this prayer with me. Say this with me. My dear God in heaven.
My dear God in heaven.
I believe tonight. That Jesus Christ. He is the Son of God.
I believe.
That he died on the cross. That he rose on the third day. Lord Jesus.
Come into my heart.
Be my Lord.
Be my Savior.
Thank you tonight. For forgiving me of all my sins. And accepting me tonight. Into your kingdom. I am.
Born again.
By the blood of the Lamb. And the word of my testimony. In Jesus' name. Amen. Oh, hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Now, if you prayed that prayer tonight, I ask you, let us know. You can put it on comments there if you like. If you want it more personal, send it. Send an email to RevBob, R-E-V-B-O-B, at CFFChurch.org, or call the church, 973-209-7786. Let us know. Let us bless you. Let us pray for you. God is good. Amen. Again, remember, if you're in the neighborhood, just please stop by, grab some of the free items we have out there. Stay connected online. Write some comments. Reverend Bob, come on up here as we are going to wrap up in prayer. Diane is going to pray a blessing over you, but we're going to pray over the prayer requests tonight. Amen. Many have come in. I'm just holding one as symbolic. Many have come in online. Many have come in different ways. We're here to pray for you. We're here to help you in any way we can. Reverend Bob, go ahead and pray for the people tonight.
Well, thank you, Lord. We praise and we bless you and we give honor to the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord, that we can come before you to glorify you on this most precious night. And Lord, we thank you right now, Lord, for our leaders, for those in authority over us, our president, vice president, Father, Secretary of State, our Congress members, Lord God. We raise them all up before you. We pray for unity within that structure. We thank you, Lord God, that they, Father, govern for the good of the people, and we praise you for that. And Lord, we just thank you also, Lord God, for our military, our first responders, our EMTs, nurses, doctors, Father, the volunteers, the chaplains that are in the hospitals, nursing homes, Lord God, all those ones, Father, we pray for protection over them, and we thank you for that. Lord, we also thank you for our military, Lord God, that's out there right now, serving in so many places, Lord. Our National Guard, our Marines, our Air Force, our Army personnel, our Naval personnel, our Coast Guard that's out there, Father, and that, Lord, you protect and watch over them, and that they are a blessing to many people around this world. And now, Lord, also, we raise up our personal prayer requests before you, Father. There are so many people out there right now, Lord, that are affected by this time. Lord, we come against depression In the name of Jesus, yes, we break its authority. We thank you that the spirit of fear has no hold on any single person, but that, Lord, you've given us power, love, and a sound mind.
Yes, Lord.
And Lord, now we also thank you that you heal your people, that you keep them peaceful, and that you keep them in safety. And Lord, that your protection goes out over them. And we thank you that we can come together and take over the airwaves for Jesus Christ. We praise you for this, and we thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And Bob, just stay here for a moment. Just before Diane sends out the blessing tonight, I just want to put a big thank you to our EMT workers, to our doctors out there, our nurses, first responders out there, firemen, policemen, all of you military that are out there, you that are serving in so many ways, helping us out that we could stay safe in our homes. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Receive this blessing from Diane tonight. And all of you are out there. As our president said last night, we're all doing our part by having this social distancing. Yes. We're all doing our part in this battle against this crazy virus. Yeah. Diane, would you go ahead?
The Bible says the Lord bless you and keep you, protect you, sustain you, and guard you. The Lord make his face shine upon you with favor and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance, his face upon you with divine approval and give you peace, a tranquil heart and life. We confess that we are the head and not the tail. We are above only and not beneath. That in all our ways and endeavors, we are greatly blessed, highly favored, and deeply loved. We are blessed to be a blessing. Thanks so much for worshiping with us.
Happy Good Friday.
Happy Good Friday.
See you Saturday night or Sunday. Amen.
Amen.
He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Come on, type that in comments. Come on, because we're gaming towards Resurrection Sunday now. He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
God bless. Have a great evening, guys.